Courts Young Lions fans, and welcome to the Courts Young Lions magazine show. The past few weeks have been a roller coaster with its share of ups and downs, but we have emerged even stronger before our next match against Tampines Rovers. First up, the Courts Young Lions travelled to Haukang, but it wasn't easy battling the home crowd and tough opposition. An encouraging return for Hanif Sadiq, who returned to the squad after missing 15 matches due to injury. And what a comeback it was! Hanif tapping home from close range after a bit of help from Nazrul Nazari. Nazrul was without a doubt the best player on the pitch, but he had his own troubles. Eventually, he had to be replaced by Fazli Ayub just before the break with an ankle injury. A blow to the Courts Young Lions, but a boost for the opposition as they eventually scored the equaliser. Nonetheless, the Courts Young Lions fought hard to salvage a draw.
It's never easy to play against an aggressive side like Haugang United. They are also an experienced team. The boys did well. We performed up to our best and we did well enough to get a point down here.
Yes, definitely. I think the Young Lions were the better side in the first 20 minutes. My team took time to settle down. Young Lions scored, yeah. I think they punished us through our lack of concentration at the back, you know. Was a well-taken goal.
The next few encounters were sadly blows to our pride. In our match against Home United, the hosts took the lead with two soft goals in the first half. Coach Robin made some crucial changes at the break in an attempt to shake up the game, bringing on Shahir Hamza and Fazli Ayub. The Courts Young Lions managed to hold off Home United in the second half, but were unable to make up the difference. 2-0, it ended.
We conceded two soft goals in the first half, but the boys showed great determination and attitude that they want to fight and come back. And we showed that in the second half, but we just couldn't get the goals today.
Clementi Stadium was an unforgiving place for our Courts Young Lions as we faced Tanjung Pagar United. Two early goals and a red card to Zulfami Arifin just after the half-hour mark pretty much sealed our fate. A ray of hope for the Courts Young Lions as we fought valiantly to half the deficit through Fazli Ayub. All this despite playing with just 10 men. But it was not meant to be, and the Courts Young Lions had to leave Clementi empty-handed.
With 10 men, the boys really fought and gave their best. But then again, it wasn't enough, and we got to step up for the next game definitely, and we got to play like the way we played in the second half.
Meanwhile, at Topayo Stadium, we took on Balestier Khalsa. It was not just a case of the Courts Young Lions against the Tigers, we had another obstacle in our midst, the weather. Nevertheless, the Courts Young Lions got down to the task at hand, but were unable to hold off the Tigers for long, conceding an early goal. Despite the challenges we faced, Coach Robin still has faith in our squad, and we do too.
The boys tried their best, played really well, just didn't have the luck today, but I'm sure it's a good step up. We want to take this performance along with us the next game and definitely get the 3 points the next time round.
Some of the Courts Young Lions were kept busy at the start of the month on the national front and were called to serve their country. Across the causeway, some Courts Young Lions took part in the 10th anniversary of the Sultan of Selangor Cup, and we can certainly be proud of them. 1-0 it finished. In Singapore, our national team played well against Jordan and created a lot of opportunities, but unfortunately, we were unable to find the break we were looking for. Courts Young Lions stars Haris Harun, Safwan Baharudin and Izwan Mahmud started and played well. Second half subs Khairul Nizam and Sharan Sulaiman also proved dangerous at times. Jordan was the better team on the day, but it's not over just yet for Singapore as we still have a shot at World Cup qualification. Nevertheless, we are still proud of the performance by the brave Court Young Lions on that day.
We did not take our chances when we had the chances. That's important at this level, you know. When you're given two or three chances, at least you have to put at least one or two balls in the back of the net, you know. I think the boys tried very hard, you know. And I think that with time with these young boys, we have a future with this team, you know. I mean, you saw they fought until the final whistle. You know, we scored the goal, I think, in the last couple of minutes. They are trying their best, you know. But sometimes things don't work out for you, you know. We still have a chance, you know. With these three games, if we can collect the maximum points, we'll give it a shot. But in football, you know, anything is possible. We will do our best.
We can take comfort in how Singapore's under-23 squad performed against Thailand, with the majority of the Court's Young Lions squad lending their talents to the nation. 25 seconds was all it took for Singapore to signal their intentions through Court's Young Lions Hafiz Sujad. Our Court's Young Lions scored all three goals in the 3-2 win. Fazli Ayub with a second, Shafiq Ghani with a stunning shot that sealed victory for Singapore. So it was all about the triumph of youth against Thailand. But check out these lucky kids from Changde Primary School who got a taste of life on the pitch at the Jalan Besar Stadium. We could be watching the future stars of Singapore football in action. Watch the space. But don't worry, we've saved the best for last. And even better, it happened back home at the Jalan Besar Stadium as the Court's Young Lions faced Woodlands Wellington. Gabriel Kwok opened the scoring for us in the 31st minute, but Woodlands kept us on our toes with an equaliser just before the halftime whistle. During halftime, these four brave participants took part in the crossbar challenge, where they stood to win a $500 Court's voucher. Bad news for them, no one won. Good news for you is that the amount has now snowballed to $1,000, which you can win if you take part during the next home game. So, a minor blip in the first half as the Court's Young Lions surged ahead in the second half. Erwan Shah with a rocket that signalled our recent troubles could now be over. Clearly the fitter of the two teams, the Court's Young Lions were now running rings against Woodlands. But we were still hungry for more. Faris Ramli and Haris Harun providing goals number 3 and 4. There's still time for one more. Nigel Vanu with the icing on the cake. A sensational victory, 5-1 it ended, and the Court's Young Lions get the confidence booster that we were looking for, especially before our next match against Tampines Rovers.
We got a win that we always wanted, 3 points, and second half performance was definitely good.
So after back-to-back games that we actually lost, we finally found our touch back, our goal-scoring touches. And it's good that we won, and also we took our chances well. And yeah, you saw for yourself, we got 5 goals in the back of the net.
It's a good way to get momentum going for the SEA Games. And for me, for my goal, I mean, I think I had some luck as well because it was deflected by a defender. So it's a good way to set the momentum going for SEA Games.
The team did well, also individually and as a teamwork. We have fighting spirit after we against Thailand. So it's a good boost for us lah. So basically, next up, Rovers, try our best.
Don't forget to come down to the Tampines Stadium to support the Court's Young Lions on Saturday, the 22nd of October. The match kicks off at 7:30 p.m. and we want all of you to be there.